As usual, is Teacher Kirwa. Feel free, as usual, let us interact. Keep the comments in the comment box, and God will bless us all. So this is our Chemistry Wednesday, as we have been doing since 7th of May to date. We thank God that we are faring on well. I want to thank all of you for having viewed my videos, those who have shared and also liked. So I want to welcome all the students, high school students, to come in and let us look at this together. So those who have tuned, you are welcome. Those who will tune in later on also, you are all welcome. You can also, don't forget to like my YouTube channel, Teacher Kirwa. Hit the red button to subscribe. And then you can put on the bell too, so that any videos that are put there in your absentia, you can be able to access them later on. And then you can also like the videos there, and let us help each other grow. So welcome. As we have been doing for the past few Wednesdays, we have been talking about organic chemistry. We have looked at organic chemistry 1. Now we are looking at organic chemistry 2. This is a brand new one that we started last week. So this organic chemistry 2, that is alkanols, alkanoic acids, detergents, and thereafter we shall look at polymers. So in our introductory part of this lesson last week, we talked about the chemistry of alkanols. We defined the alkanols. We said these are organic compounds which have OH as a functional group, and the OH being a functional group is called ol. It has the suffix ol. So these are alkanols. We looked at nomenclature of alkanols, and we said they are named by replacing the last name, the last word of alkanes. You replace the last letter E with ol, so that you have alkanol. So that is nomenclature. We also looked at isomerism, where we said alkanols exhibit two types of isomerism, that is branching isomerism and positional isomerism. Positional isomerism due to the presence of the double bond, and then we have branching isomerism due to the position and the type of the branch. That is either can be an alkyl or a halogen, just as we have been looking at these isomers in the past lessons. So today, having looked at preparation of alkanols, how they are prepared in the lab, today I want us to look at chemical properties of alkanols, and we discuss them in details. So the first chemical property of alkanols is combustion. Of course, as we had said earlier on, combustion is burning in presence of oxygen. So when we were looking at organic chemistry 1, I did mention that all organic compounds, when they are burnt in air, also as done in form 1, that is hydrocarbons, all organic compounds, when they are burnt, the products are water and carbon 4 oxide. So if we have, so we'll be using ethanol as an example to represent the other alkanols. So when ethanol is burnt, we'll have carbon 4 oxide and water. Those are the products. Balancing gives you two, three. Then oxygen is four, 7. So this is 7 over 3. Okay, so that is when this is burnt, you have carbon dioxide and water. So these are gas, this liquid, this gas, this liquid. Number 2 or B is reaction with metals. Reaction with metals. The metal we are talking about, we have sodium, potassium, magnesium, and all the other metals that we've been discussing since Form 2. So when ethanol C2 reacts with sodium, for example, we are using sodium to represent the other metals, then you have C2H5O sodium and hydrogen gas. You have two. Yes, hydrogen is 6. This is 10. So what happens here is that this hydrogen is replaced by sodium. So you have, this is ethanol, this one is sodium. Now this compound is called sodium ethoxide. Sodium ethoxide. This sodium ethoxide is a base. So the hydrogen is replaced by sodium. So that you have, no, this is not water. Sorry, this is hydrogen gas. Not water. That's hydrogen gas. Sorry for that. So this is sodium ethoxide plus hydrogen gas. So those are the two products that are formed when sodium reacts with ethanol. And same to all the other metals. So you can have potassium ethoxide, potassium propoxide, etc. Now this sodium ethoxide hydrolyzes in water. It undergoes hydrolysis in water to produce hydroxide ions. Okay, so it hydrolyzes in water to produce hydroxide ion, meaning this one is alkalines. So all these alkoxides are alkaline or basic in nature. So this is what happens when the metals react with alkanols. 3 or C, how you number them? So C is called esterification. Esterification reaction. So we've looked at two already. So let's look at esterification. Esterification is a reaction of alkanol and an alkanoic acid. Alkanoic acid to form a compound called an ester. This is ethanoic acid. Okay, this is an ethanoic acid. Ethanoic acid because it has two carbons. We shall be discussing alkanoic acids later on. So for this particular topic, we are only doing this so that we get the chemical property of alkanols. So an ethanol reacts with ethanoic acid. Now this is what happens, and I want us to pay some attention here. So you have this OH. This OH reacts with that O, with that H. Okay, the OH of ethanol reacts with the H of ethanoic acid to form water. Okay, you realize that these are two hydrogens and one oxygen. So I've said OH combines with the H to form water. Okay, so one of the products is water. Now, we want to join the remaining, starting with the with this part. So, when the other product now, you have CH3COO, okay, the hydrogen is taken away. And then you bring this one on this side. So, you have C2H5, okay? Did you get that? You have ethanol, take away the CH. So, when you take away the CH, just for clarity, not the CH, the OH. When you take the OH, the next thing you do is you write the general formula, and now you start with this. Okay, you start with this. So we are having something like CH3COO, and then you attach the one from the ethanol on this side. Now let us name this compound. You remember when we were in Form 1, we talked about this. Okay, this is sulfuric 6 acid. When you take away the hydrogen, you have SO4, okay? This one is referred to as sulfate. So, sulfuric 6 acid, this one is sulfate. The other one is this. This is weak carbonic acid. When you take away the hydrogen, you have CO32 carbonate, okay? So, you realize this one ends with ATE, carbonate, sulfate, phosphate, okay, etc. Now this also we have called it ethanoic acid. Okay, we are calling it ethanoic acid. Now we are taking away the hydrogen. You know, the hydrogen is the proton that always gives substances the acidic property. So you have H here. When you take away H, so that you have this, by the way, that one is negative, this negative. So when you have that, it is called ethanoate. So this one is called ethanoate. Okay, it's called ethanoate. Ethanoate, the 8, it was ethanoic acid. The 8 comes because we have taken away the proton or the hydrogen. So you have ethanoate. Of course, this one is C2H5. It is synonymous with, if you remember, C2H6. This C2H6, we call it ethane. Okay, this ethane. Now, when you take away one hydrogen, so that you have C2H5, we said it's called ethyl. So, this one is ethyl. Are we together? This is ethyl. This is ethanoate. Okay? Now, when we are naming the compound, we call it ethyl ethanoate. So, the name of this compound is called ethyl ethanoate. You see how the name comes about? Ethyl is this from the ethanol. Ethanoate is this one from ethanoic acid. So the compound is called ethyl ethanoate. And this compound is the one we are calling it an ester. So this one is belongs to a group of compounds called esters. So this is an ester. Esters, just to mention, is when you have, we have talked of alkanes, alkenes, alkynes. Now we've talked of alkanols. We shall also talk about alkanoic acids. So when you go a bit further, you will look at ester. Ester is another group of organic compounds. So this is ethyl ethanoate. Okay, let us look at another example of the same kind. Maybe we take this was ethanol and ethanoic acid. Let me take ethanol and propanoic acid reacting with CH3CH2COOH. This is propanoic acid. Propanoic acid. So what do you have? Okay. Same thing we have done. Take this hydrogen. The OH. Sorry. OH, and it takes away the hydrogen there. Okay, so you have water. Okay, you have water because OH and H forms water. The next one is, so water plus, now this other one is, we have said you begin with this and then this. So you realize when you take away OH here, you have C2H5. Okay, and on this other side, you have CH3CH2COO. Okay, so we have said this one is ethyl. This ethyl. This one is propanoate. Propanoate. Propanoate is from propanoic acid. This one is propanoic acid, so you have propanoate. So that is what we have. Now, when you are drawing, we have said you begin with the propanoate and then this one goes to the other end. So you have CH3, CH2, COO, and then C2H5. Okay? So the name is ethyl propanoate. So this one is called ethyl propanoate. Okay? Ethyl propanoate. So that is what we have. Is called esterification. Ethyl propanoate is the ester. Okay? So you can have a look at that. Okay, so I hope that one is clear. So that is esterification. So let me do a reverse of this. Just one more example. One more example. Let us say we have a we name an ester. Okay. Let me say butyl. Butanoate. So first of all, let us look at butyl butanoate. So butyl, we know is C4. So butyl, this is CnH2n+1. So if it is but, we know is 4 carbon atoms. So butyl is C4H, it should be H10, so it will be H9. Okay, that's butanoate, butyl. Now, butanoate, we have CH3CH2CH2COOH. 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon atoms to make it butanoate. So, because it is OH, we don't have the hydrogen. So, that. Now, when we are drawing butyl butanoate, this is C. You begin with this and then this, so this CH3CH2CH2COO and then C4H9. This is now butyl butanoate, this compound. Now if you want to go back, so looking at this, you know you can come back, okay? You can come back from ethyl ethanoate to find out the reactants, alright? Because ethyl is from ethanol, ethanoate is from ethanoic acid. Similarly here, in our example here, butyl is from butanol, okay? So butyl, the name butyl, this one came from butanol. Butanoate came from butanoic acid. Okay, so butanoate, butanoic acid. Now, for you to get the reactants, you just, for the butyl, you just add OH here. For this one, you just add hydrogen. So, the what forms that is C4H9OH plus that CH3CH2COOH. Okay, so now you get this. When you go back, you will have butanol. This butanol, this is butanoic acid. As simple as that. So you can always go back wherever you are, so long as you know that the first name comes from the alkanol, the second name comes from the alkanoic acid. Of course, you cannot draw this in an exam. You can the only thing you do is to get the products. You can as well go back and get the reactants. So that is it. Sometimes this reaction may be slow, so the reaction may be slow. So conc sulfuric 6 acid is added to catalyze. So when the sometimes this reaction is slow, so to enable it to be a bit faster, then sulfuric 6 acid, a few drops of sulfuric 6 acid is added in order to speed up that reaction. Just a minute. Alright. So that is called esterification. A reaction of an alkanol and an alkanoic acid to form an ester. So that was number C. D is oxidation reaction. Oxidation reaction. Now, oxidation reaction, as we looked at for alkenes and alkynes, is that oxidation reaction is a reaction of an organic compound with an oxidizing agent. If you remember, we said we have two major oxidizing agents in chemistry, that is potassium manganate 7, and then we have potassium dichromate 6. Okay, these are the major oxidizing agents in chemistry. Now, these oxidizing agents add, when you add, they add an oxygen atom to the compound. So, for example, if we have ethanol, by the way, ester, I did not mention ester. And ester, this ethyl, methyl methanoate, ethyl ethanoate, butyl propanoate, etc. And ester is a sweet smelling compound. Okay, ester is a sweet smelling compound. If you have taken a banana, a ripe banana, there is that sweet smell that a banana has. That is because it contains an ester. So oxidation reaction is a reaction of alkanol with an oxidizing agent. For example, you have ethanol, C2H5. So if you have that, it undergoes oxidation. I told you an oxidation reaction can be represented using that. This is acidified potassium manganate 7 or acidified potassium dichromate 6. Any one of these. So it can be acidified potassium manganate 7 or acidified potassium dichromate 6. So when ethanol undergoes this reaction, then you have C2H5. Okay, let me write. It will be COOH. So this is CH3 COOH. Okay. Now, this ethanol. And this is ethanoic acid. So, alkanols undergo oxidation to form alkanoic acids. Okay? Alkanols undergo oxidation to form alkanoic acid. As simple as that. If you had methanol, it forms methanoic acid. If you had propanol, propanoic acid. ETC. The only points that we need to note here are as follows. When is that? When potassium manganate 7 is used, the color changes. The color changes from purple to colorless. So the purple color of potassium manganate 7 changes to colorless, or in short, the purple color is decolorized. And if it is in the case of potassium dichromate 6, the orange color changes to green. So in the process of oxidation, the alkanol changes to alkanoic acid, and the potassium manganate 7, if it is used, changes from purple to colorless, or the purple color is decolorized. And for potassium dichromate 6, the orange color of potassium dichromate 6 is orange in color. So the orange color changes to green. That is during oxidation. Now, this one of potassium dichromate 6, this reaction is used in breathalyzers. To show the amount of alcohol. Okay, breathalyzer is what has been used by policemen, traffic police. Wakati wana, you understand, they say you don't drink and drive. If you drink and you drive, when you encounter the drivers, no, ukifika kwa roadblock, ama penye traffic police wako, they give a breathalyzer. This breathalyzer, inside it contains acidified potassium dichromate 6. So when this drunken driver blows into the breathalyzer, then the orange color changes to green. Alright? And that shows that either you are very drunk. Now, the rate at which the orange color fades, the orange color changes to green, shows how much. Of course, if it is too much alcohol, as soon as, no sooner had you breathed, okay, if there is English like that, no sooner had you breathed in than the color changes. So that means the driver has taken a lot of alcohol. So this particularly potassium dichromate 6. So that's what happens. That was D. Number E, and this is what we have done already, is the reaction with Kong sulfuric 6 acid. reaction with coke sulfuric 6 acid. This is what we already have done. It was called dehydration. Remember dehydration? So C2H5OH reacts with sulfuric 6 acid. Let me not say react. Let me put it along the arrow. So, at 180 degrees Celsius, you have C2H2. This is ethene, okay, and water. This gas, this is. So, if you remember, this one was ethene. Ethene is formed as a reaction, as a means, is formed from the dehydration of alkanol by coke sulfuric 6 acid. So this process we said is called dehydration. So this is dehydration. Where the coke sulfuric 6 acid acts as a dehydrating agent. Okay, the other version of this, if the temperatures are not 180, if you have C2H5OH coke sulfuric 6 acid, coke sulfuric 6 acid is always liquid, then we have 140. So instead of 180, you remember we said this temperature should be 160 to 180. If it is below 160, maybe 140 to 160 there, then you will not have ethene. You will have this compound here. It will be C2H5. Okay. This one is called an ether. The name is diethyl ether. Another group of compounds called ethers. Ethers contains one oxygen between. So diethyl, because in ethyl, C2H5 is ethyl, C2H5 ethyl, so they are two. That's why it's called diethyl. And then the compound is ether. So this is that is the reaction that this chemical, these alkanols undergo. So this one is dehydration. Now this is incomplete dehydration. Okay, incomplete dehydration gives you diethyl ether, or simply you can say an ether. So those are five chemical reactions in which alkanols take where is it in which or where. So those are the five chemical properties of alkanols. They form the five chemical reactions. We have combustion, we have reaction with metals, we have esterification, we have oxidation reaction, and then we have reaction with coke sulfuric 6 acid. So those are the five chemical properties of alkanols for today's lesson. Let me just leave you to find out the uses of alkanols. Okay. So hiyo ndio asaimo uende ufanye. You can submit it here for verification, but find out the uses of alkanols. So that marks the end of alkanols. In our next lesson, we shall look at alkanoic acids, and then we discuss the detergents. So folks, that is our lesson for today. I hope you have enjoyed the lesson. For those who will view offline, I hope you will also be able to enjoy. Let us help each other grow. Share these videos, and all of us will gain at the end of the day. These are free lessons. There are no payments to be made. However, the M-Pesa number is down here. You can, yes, credit is not. But otherwise, it is free. You only need a smartphone. you also need bundles, a pen, and a book. And then you sit down at the comfort of your living room and watch. Okay? I'm here for you. Let us help each other pass exams. For those who are grown-ups, please let this reach out to all the your siblings, your brothers, sisters, your friends, and also neighbors as we learn from home. After this, the videos will be available in YouTube. The name is Teacher Kirwa. Don't forget to subscribe. God bless you all. Till next time, sanitize, stay at home. Bye-bye.